Hello everyone, welcome to Amarjyoti's Crochet World. Today I'm here again with the second part of making this angel. In the first part we have made the doll or the figure of angel, and in this part we are going to make the arms and the wings and the hair and the halo or nimbus for this angel. So first of all we are going to start making this hand. So making this arm or hand, we need the same light beige color that we used for the head of angel. So the same I am going to use in the white color yarn, same. And the crochet hook that we used for making the doll or the angel was 2.5 mm crochet hook, and the same 2.5 mm crochet hook I am going to use for this project also. And we need this pair of scissors, tapestry needle and stitch marker, as we will be working in the spirals again, so we need a stitch marker. So let's begin making the hands or the arms. Again make a magic circle, chain one and make six single crochet in the magic circle. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Pull the yarn or pull the end, and then again one single crochet. Row number 2 will be one single crochet in each of the stitches, and total stitch count will be 6 again. So 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. One single crochet in each of the stitches, and total stitch count remained 6. Row number 3, we are going to make an increase. 1 single crochet in first stitch, 2 single crochet in the next, 1 single crochet in the first stitch. Just a second, let me mark the first stitch. I have forgotten. Okay, and 2 single crochet in the next, 1 single crochet in the first, 2 single crochet in the second. So total stitch count after this row is 9. Now in the next row, row number 4, 1 single crochet in each of the stitches, and total stitch count will be 9. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Now after this round I am going to decrease. Total stitch count was 9, now I am going to decrease it to 6 again. So 1 in the first and 2 stitches from next 2 and 3 will be stitched together. The sequence will be 1 single crochet and a decrease, and a decrease. Again 1 single crochet and a decrease. So total stitch count after this row is 6. Make 1 single crochet again, that is stitch count will be 6. 2 3 4 5 and 6. After this, in the next stitch make a slip stitch, chain one and finish it off, and cut very small amount of yarn because we don't need this color anymore here. So hide the tail. The hand is ready. Now we are going to make the dress. Attach white color yarn and one single crochet in each of the stitches. That is, total stitch count remains 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The next row we are going to increase to 9 again. So again our sequence will be one single crochet in the first stitch and two single crochet in the next stitch. 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5 and 6. 7, 8 and 9. So total stitch count becomes 9 again. After this row, I'm going to make 10 rows was of one single crochet in each stitch. That is, total stitch count will be 9. For next 10 rows, I'll be working for one single crochet in each of the next in each of the 9 stitches. So I'll meet you when I'll make the 10 rows of this one single crochet in each of the stitches. I have made both the arms, so let's attach the arms with the body. Take your needle and then take one arm in the tail. And start sewing like this, not the straight one, a bit tilted towards the front side, because I am going to make her stand like holding her hands together. So attach the arms on both the sides by sewing properly. Tie knot to secure it and hide the tail. So one arm is done like this, and the second arm also I'm going to sew the second arm also. Like this. Tie a tight knot. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm not hiding the tail. I'm just passing the yarn or passing the needle till the tip of the head. Like this. I have passed the yarn till the head. And now, I'm going to make both the hands holding together like this. Sew both the hands together and then attach the hands with the body also, so they will remain in the position where they are kept right now. Make 2 knots at least and then hide the yarn and cut the extra yarn. Here it is. So she is holding her hands together and I have stitched it over here. Now we have done this much. Now we are going to make the wings. One wing I have already done, so the second wing we are going to make. For making this wing, again we are using the same white color yarn. Make chain 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Chain 12. Now, in the third stitch from the hook, we are going to make a half double crochet. Yarn over the hook, leave two chain stitches, and in the third, make one half double crochet like this. We are going to make 6 half double crochet in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In next 4 stitches, we will be working 1 single crochet in each of the 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. The stitches closer to the inner side. All 4 stitches I have done 1 single crochet in each of the stitches. So after this I have done half double crochet, but these 4 stitches will remain constant as single crochet in each of the 4 stitches. So here I have done 12, chain 12, left 2 stitches, and in the third stitch I have done 1 half double crochet and 1 half double crochet in the 6 stitches in total, and 7, 8, 9 and 10. 4 stitches I have done 1 single crochet. Turn your work. I am not chaining 1. I am just again making 1 single crochet in the same stitch. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1 single crochet in the 4 stitches. Again make 1 half double crochet on the half double crochet, that is 6 half double crochets, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 6 half double crochet. After that make chain 4. Chain 4, turn your work. Again make a half double crochet, leaving 2 stitches, and in the third stitch make 1 half double crochet, in the next stitch make second half double crochet, and again the next 6 half double crochets as it is, as we have done in the last round. 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, sorry, 6th is also half double crochet. After 6 half double crochets, we have left 4, that is 1 single crochet in each of the 4 stitches, 3, 4. Again turn your work, 1 single crochet in the same stitch without chain 1, making chain 1, then 2nd single crochet, 3rd single crochet and 4th single crochet. Again make 1 half double crochet in each of the stitches till end, and total half double crochet will be 8. Then half double crochet on each of the half double crochet. Like this. Now again make chain 4. Turn your work. Leave 2 stitches, and in the 3rd stitch again make a half double crochet, and in the next stitch also again make a half double crochet. Next 8 half double crochet as it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. After that 1 single crochet in each of the 4 stitches, 3 and 4. Turn your work, again make 4 single crochet, 4. After that, as we have done total 10 half double crochet, now we will be working 8 half double crochet only. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Chain 2, turn your work, again half double crochet, 1 half double crochet in the same stitch, and total will be 8 half double crochet in total, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 4 single crochet as usual in the center, 2, 3 and the fourth one. Turn your work, again make 4 single crochet on the 4 single crochets, 3, 4. Now we had done 8 half double crochet, this time we will be working 6 half double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Chain 2. Turn your work and again make a half double crochet in the same stitch and 6 half double crochet in total, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 4 single crochet as usual in the center, towards the center actually. This portion we have done till this. Now we will be decreasing once more. Turn your work, again make 4 single crochet on the 4 single crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now as we have done 6 half double crochet, now we will be working 4 half double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 half double crochet. Chain 2. This time we are not going to chain 2. Just half double crochet, turn your work and then slip stitch in the first 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3. We have reached the third stitch, chain 2 and in the same stitch make a half double crochet, again make a half double crochet and now the 4 stitches with single crochet, 2, 3, 4. Turn your work, four single crochet, 2, 3 and 4. See, now we have reached at this point. Here I have reached here. Now I am going to make a chain and make it a protruding wing, you can say a long wing at the end. Now I am going to make, I have made 4 single crochet, then 2 half double crochet, chain 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, turn your work and in the third chain start making half double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 2 half double crochet of the last round. That is total 8 half double crochet we have done, and 4 single crochet. Turn your work, 4 single crochet, 4. Now we have 8 half double crochet, and so now we will be working only 4 half double crochet. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Turn your work, slip stitch in the 3 stitches. First 3 stitches, slip stitch, 1, slip stitch in the second and slip stitch in the third, and chain 2, in the same stitch make a half double crochet, again in the next stitch make a half double crochet, in next 2 stitches make chain single crochet, and last 2 stitches you are going to slip stitch like this. Chain 1 and leave a long tail to sew the wings and finish it off. So here your wings are ready. We will be attaching both the wings. So both the wings are ready like this. So let's attach both the wings. Take the tail of one wing, and then let's take them like this. In either way you can take, because both the wings are similar. And start sewing like this. One stitch from this side and one stitch from that side. So both the wings are there. These two tails I am leaving because I will be hiding inside the body of the angel. So just tie a tight knot and then leave it over here. So your wings are ready. Attach both the wings at the back side of the angel. Like this. Attaching the wings with the other end, that is of the tail of the second wing that I had left. Just leaving about 2 or 3 rows from the top, and then start sewing in the center at the back side. hide the tails inside the work, and then cut the extra yarns. I'm just pulling with the help of my crochet hook. It inside and cut the extra yarn. So now the wings are attached to the angel. Because in the center they were like this, they were curved, that is why they looks like they are flying in a flying position. Otherwise they would have been straight, but I have made them in a flying position, so like this. So the angel with wings and the body arms is ready. Now we are going to make the hair. For making the hair, I am using this, as I told you, the gray color or silver color yarn with a furry look. So cut about 10 to 12 inches long pieces of this yarn. I'll cut this much yarn and then I'll show you how to attach the hair to the angel. Okay, now I have cut these strands. Take two strands of this yarn, fold in the half and take the center and start pulling through the head of the angel, and then make a loop like this, like this. Take two strands of the yarn, fold in a half with the help of your crochet hook, pull through the work and then tie a knot like this. Like this, I'll be covering the whole head. We are going to make a single braid of the angel. Like this. Take two strands and then pull with the help of your crochet hook and through this make like this, and here I'm going to attach it. Any kind of hairstyle you want to make, you can make to the angel, with the short hair or with the long hair. I am going to make the braid. You can make the braid also, open hair, curly hair, any kind of. So let me finish till this and then the head will be covered. I'll meet you after attaching these here. I have attached the knots or the hair like this, and at the back I have made a braid to one side and then cut the extra yarns or hair Now her hair are ready. Only the halo or nimbus is there. So as in the first video, I had told you I am going to take the gold yellow color and the light yellow color. Both yarns together. Chain 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Chain 20. Okay. And leave 2 stitches. And in the third stitch, make a half double crochet. Make one half double crochet in each of the stitches till end. Total 18 half double crochets we will be having. It's a two shaded color, gold and light yellow. You can take any shade of yellow color only or any shade of gold color only, just to make a glowing halo on the head of the angel. So here it is. So it's done. Chain one and leave a long tail and finish it off. Take your needle and pass both the threads through the eye of the needle. We are going to sew it. Okay, now attach both the ends together. One thing you could do is just attach it like here and then do a half double crochet in a circular way, but I have done it like this. I have made a single piece and then I'm going to attach it like this. You can do in any manner that makes you comfortable in working. So like this I have done. Okay, this is done. Now I'm going to sew it over the head. Like this. The other method to attach this nimbus is you can use the glue, but again I prefer to sew my work than gluing it, because glue makes it a messy project, so, and I don't like gluing and all that. I'm just attaching by sewing the parts. And then just pulling the hair and bringing the yarn below and then tie a knot under the wig and then hide the tail. And cut the extra yarn. Again, pull this yarn also, this tail also, and then cut it. It is done. So now your angel Gabriel is ready. Baby Jesus, I have done in the last video that I have uploaded earlier. An angel Gabriel I have done with this beautiful wings. If you feel that these wings are very much, because white color is very much glowing color, so if you feel that you are not able to make it see it clearly in the video, please mention in the comment section. I will make in any other color to make the wings clear, because these wings are very beautiful. I have done and I love these wings very much. The texture, the way, the work, the design, I love the wings. So please like my video. Hope you like this angel Gabriel. So please like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and please write in the comment section also how you like my video. And thank you for watching my channel, and also don't forget to press the bell icon. You will get the notification after every upload I will make. So thank you for watching my channel once again. Thank you for watching my videos and appreciating my work. It really means a lot to me, and thank you once again.